On a eu l'une des parties les plus compliquées dans le sympa de Mishpatim. It's very hard to know to say exactly how the logical of the sugya was built. C'est très dur de pouvoir dire exactement comment la logique de la sugya a été construite. If you try to make it simple, si on essaie de le faire très simplement, Nahash, let's say, the Zaken, is afraid to say one sod. He's very afraid. And because he don't know if people deserve to listen to that secret. Donc Nahash, il a très peur de dire un secret, c'est pas si les gens méritent de dire ce secret. And he start to talk. We thought that it was the beginning of the sugya. And at the end of this talk, his soul said, the soul of the Zaken said to the Zaken, please start to talk now. Let's make us crazy. Don't make us crazy. You bring us in many ways. You didn't start to talk yet. Donc on était en train de discuter, le Nahash il parlait, enfin le Zaken il parlait. Et à un moment, on pensait que ça avait commencé l'explication. Sa Neshama dit, sa propre Neshama lui dit, commence à parler. So, what was all the speech done about that big introduction before the Zaken start to speak? C'était quoi tout ce long discours qui a été dit par le Zaken avant qu'il commence réellement à parler? It was about Aravot. Aravot meaning the plants we have in the lulav. We have two aravot. And he said, this was emuna. Il disait, ça c'est la emuna. We connect that to Sukkot. On a connecté ça à Sukkot. We open one kitvari, talking about two gvurot, being the netzach and the hod of gvurot of that. He said that Netzar and Od, they are the two aravot that you have in the lulav. Il dit que Netzar et Od, c'est les deux aravot que tu as dans le lulav. And he said, among the five gvurot, à l'intérieur des cinq gvurot, il dit, they are hidden. Ils sont caché. Let's all. He said also that the two aravot, meaning let's all, they will only be sweetened, make sweet, being sweet, in the returning light. Et dit aussi que les deux aravot, that the two aravot will be sweet, ils seront adoucis que dans le Or Chozer, only in the Or Chozer. Va bien, Kouma? Andy. Was basically the main explanation, the main speech. And after say something else, après d'autres choses, said that you have specific souls that are given to Gerim. Il dit t'as certains âmes qui sont données au Gerim, and that souls basically they are very high. Et ces âmes-là sont très très hautes. And basically, it's important to get them. Et c'est bien de les attirer à soi. How? That we saw Krishna Chalamita, you bring to you that souls. Why? Because that souls of Girim, they are very powerful regarding Emuna. Ils disent que ces âmes-là, elles sont très puissantes au niveau de l'Emuna. So before we move forward, we have to understand that what we wrote yesterday is here to talk about the difference we have between Bitachon and Emuna. Donc on dit que ce qu'on a vu hier, c'est là en fait pour nous donner une différence profonde, la différence profonde qu'il y a entre Bitachon et Emuna. So to understand what we studied yesterday, we need the text now. So I'm sending to you the text you're going to read now. After we continue the Zohar. Donc, le texte qu'on a vu hier, il est là pour poser une réalité, une différence qu'il y a entre Bitachon et Emuna. Et on va voir maintenant le texte du Hari qui explique ça. Donc, sans le texte d'aujourd'hui, on ne pouvait pas comprendre de quoi il s'agissait hier. So first of all, we go to Sefer HaLikutim. I'll send you the picture, 1 second. First text, comment text. Let me know when you receive. Before we receive, page Taf Tet Va.
C'est bon.
C'est bon. It's good.
Oui.
So what we have to know?
Taf what?
Tet.
Oh, Tet.
If what we have to know, ce qu'on doit savoir, c'est que we have two words to talk about Emuna. Many people even don't know the difference we have between Emuna and Taf Tet Vav. Taf, yes. Before you. So I said, many people don't know the difference we have between Emuna and Bitachon. Beaucoup de gens ne savent pas la différence entre Emuna et Bitachon. This is one of the secrets that we saw yesterday. We're going to try to understand it now. Beaucoup de gens ne savent pas c'est quoi la différence entre Emuna et Bitachon. C'est l'une des grandes questions, un grand secret qui a été expliqué hier, mais les gens ne savent pas c'est quoi. Why we have to understand it now? Pourquoi on doit comprendre maintenant? Because we saw that when a man makes his seder of Pesach that should be done, on a vu que quand un homme il fait son seder de Pessah comme il faut, what is for us to do the seder of Pessah like it should be done? It's when you pass from Elohim to Achdatam, right?
Right.
You get it, Elohim?
Yes.
This is the good seder of Pessah. The righteous way to make the seder of Pessah. C'est la bonne manière de faire le seder de Pessah. Why? This is the gvurot. Pourquoi? C'est les gvurot qui sont adoucis, which are being sweetened. And what Arado said, he said, when you do that, you achieve that level. What do you create? Bitachon. Quand tu fais ça comme il faut, qu'est-ce que tu crées à Pessah? Bitachon. So the Bitachon, we connect it to David. If you remember all the limud, right?
Yes.
Ce bitachon là, on l'a collecté à David, si vous rappelez de tout ce qu'on a vu. But now, something new comes to us. On a une nouvelle chose qui est venue à nous. We saw that Emuna is connected to the Aravot of Sukkot. Right?
Oui.
So before we go in the text, my question for you. What is the difference between Bitachon and Emuna? Avant qu'on aille plus loin, ma question pour vous, c'est quoi la différence entre Bitachon et Emuna? Any answers? Yes. Benita, Alan, any answer? Okay. Let's try and see. I said, comprend. Go to the first picture I sent to you. And on the right side, in the bottom. Le côté droit, à gauche. À droite, pardon, en bas. Siman Yud Zayin.
C'est bon.
Ok.
Oui.
Ko Amar Adonai. Like the, here is what says Hashem. What is what Hashem means? Arur Agever Asher Yiftar Ba'adam. Cursed be the man who will put his faith, who will believe, put his faith inside of a man. Maudit soit l'homme qui met sa confiance à l'homme. You get it? Vous avez compris?
Oui.
Do you know the pasuk?
Vous connaissez? Oui. Oui.
Okay. So it says, Arur, cursed be the man who put his faith inside of a man. Arur agever. Asher yiftar ba'adam. Ve'aya ki ara'ar be'arbe ve'chule. Be'arba ve'arbe ve'chule. Baruch ha'gever asher yiftar ba'adonai. And blessed be the man who put his confidence, his trust to Hashem. Et béni, c'est béni, soit l'homme qui va mettre sa confiance en Dieu. So what's the connection between this and what we saw yesterday? Said like this. Ra'ui le'avin. It's important to know. C'est important de savoir. Ma'em'el'u. Adimyonot shedome'e ha'adam aboter ba'adam e'arer be'arba. So my first question, what is the arer be'arba? You know what this mean? Vous savez ce que ça veut dire?
Non, attends. Arava, c'est quoi? C'est... Ah non, non, non. J'allais te demander si c'était le désert, Arava.
Any idea? Vous savez ce que ça veut dire?
Attends. Non, non, non.
So let's go to Yirmiyahu Yud Zayin. On va aller dans le Sefer Yirmiyahu Yud Zayin. If you get it, take it, please. Vous avez ça pour nous. Design. Pasuk Vav, I think. Yud Vav, Pasuk Vav. Yud Zayin, Pasuk Vav. Let's start from the Pasuk Hey. So I read in French and after I will read in English. Ainsi parle l'Éternel, maudit soit l'homme qui met sa confiance en un mortel. Prend pour appui un être de chair dont le cœur s'éloigne de Dieu. Pareil à la bruyère dans les landes, il ne verra point les deux jours propices. So in Hebrew, it's like this. Aroa geva shefta badunai, aroa geva shefta badam, besham basar zaro. Umin adunai, yasur libo. And he said, veaya ke arar be arava. What is arava? Aravot. Arava belo ire ki yavo ot of. In English, en anglais dit quoi? Go back. Go back. Thus says the Lord Hashem, cursed is the man that trusts in men and makes flesh his arm, and whose heart departeth from Hashem.
Cursed is the man who trusts in people and makes flesh and blood his strength and turns his heart away from Hashem.
Continue.
He will be like a lone tree in the desert, and he will not see when goodness comes. It dwells in parched lands.
So I say he's not a lone tree in the desert. He said that for the Pasuk 6?
Yeah.
For he shall be like a tamarisk in the desert. See? What is tamarisk? No. It's Arava. I say no. See? So connection with Arava. So, yeah. Tamarisk. So say what's happened now. We have the connection. It's parce qu'on a, on a le lien entre Arur Agever Sheftar. Donc, Iftar, Bitachon, to men. You give Bitachon, you give your trust to men. What's happened? You are like Arava, not being surrounded by waters. I want to see the leaves. Donc, we see now, let's go back to the Limud. We see now the connection. He said, if you put your trust in a man, you will be like an Arava missing waters. So what does it mean? That the Arava is, missing water is the consequences of giving the trust to men. And we saw yesterday, he was talking about this water coming from Gan Eden and which bring waters to Aravat. Remember?
Yes.
C'est ce qu'on a vu hier. Là, on voit en fait le lien qui est entre quoi? Entre le fait de mettre sa confiance en l'homme et le fait d'être un sol pleureur qui manque d'eau, qui n'est pas arrosé. On sait que le sol pleureur, il fait référence à la Emouna. We know that Garava is connected to Emuna. So do we have a connection between Emuna and Bitachon? Yes.
Est-ce qu'on a un lien entre Emuna et Bitachon?
Oui. From where? From the Pasuk. From Yirmiyahu. Curse be the man who put his trust in man. He is like a Arava missing waters. What is the code? If you are a man who put your trust in man, you will have Lake Efemuna. Ça veut dire quoi? Si tu es un homme qui met ta confiance dans un homme, tu vas avoir un manque d'Emuna. That's why the first thing we have to build in the calendar is Bitachon. When? Erev Pesach. Erev Pesach. Yes, Erev Pesach. The night of Pesach, l'El Pesach. C'est pour ça qu'on commence par Pesach, qu'on sur le Bitachon. Elokim, Ardatam. Because if you don't have the Bitachon properly built, your Sukkot is done. Your Aravot are done. Your Emunah is not standing. Parce que si tu construis pas ton année en bâtissant d'abord le Bitachon, tu ne peux pas accéder à l'Emunah. Without Bitachon, you don't have Emunah. First level of definition. Premier niveau de définition. Sans Bitachon, tu n'as pas d'Emunah. Let's see. Regardez ce qu'il dit. Raoui la ville, ma em, a dimionot, chez Adome et Adaham, abote abadam, les Arava, les Arbe. So I say, why do we connect? Why the image of the man who is using his trust in a bad way, why is it connected to the Arava? Pourquoi l'image de celui qui manque, de qui fait confiance à un homme est connectée à la Arava? He said, and what a punishment. C'est quoi la punition par rapport à ça? Et c'est Vegam, Raoul Avin, we are also to understand why. Dimion, chez Dima'a, Baal, Abitachon, les Et Chatoul, Almaim. Why people who have Bitachon are compared to tree which is surrounding by waters and is depth inside of waters? Pourquoi maintenant celui qui a du Bitachon, il est comparé à un arbre qui est planté dans l'eau et qui est entouré d'eau? You follow, it's good. Vous suivez, c'est bon?
Oui.
Omnam, Ainyambu, but here's the situation, here's the topic. Voici la situation. Vayadata, Mashikatu, Beinyan, A, Megul Galim, Shimi Galim, Betsome, Ave Domen. He said, you already know what is written about the souls who are in Gilgul inside of the minerals and the vegetals. You know? Il fait, tu sais déjà, c'est quoi ce qu'on a dit par rapport aux âmes de ceux qui sont Gilgul dans le végétal et le minéral. Do you know? Est-ce que vous savez, est-ce que nous savons? Yes, what do you know?
Rabbi.
Oui, vas-y Rabbi Carlos, yes.
Ah, c'est, enfin, de ce que je sais, c'est que les gilgulim du ce sont les gilgulim du Kafakela. Du coup, ceux qui n'ont pas pu rentrer.
Ok. Au... Got it. Ouais. Carlos, tu sais, we are gilgulim of Kafakela. You have something to add, quelque chose à rajouter encore? How do you know about that kind of sound?
Elles n'ont pas pu rentrer au Géunom, du coup, elles n'avaient pas assez de mérite pour ça, donc elles ont été envoyées dans le Kafakela pour remonter, ainsi de suite, jusqu'à pouvoir avoir la chance de rentrer et d'avoir droit à un an au Géunom, si je me souviens bien. Et pour pouvoir, en fait.
They are connected to that soil. We don't deserve to go to Géunom. They are from the Kafakela. We need to pass this to go up. Réchaï. What else? Have something else? We don't have Emuna. Yes, there's pas de Emuna. Okay, we can get it. Something else?
We have to elevate the body to
You have to, okay. On doit les élever par les manger. Yes, but what do you know about that sauce? What can you say? We'll see what it says. Say that we have to know what is said about that kind of salt, and we have to see it about the pasuk Asaf Asifam. So we open a big bracket. Donc il dit, pour comprendre ce que c'est ces âmes, il faut regarder ce qu'on a dit plus haut dans le pasuk Asaf Asifam. So how do I know? It's written in your notes. If you see, if you follow well, Gabriel, you see the notes? You see the P?
Yes.
What's using the P?
Oh,
okay. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Right.
The pasuk.
Oh.
Okay. So he said, where we stop. Donc là où on s'arrêtait, vous voyez la petite note, la petite parenthèse?
Oui, oui, yeah.
Vous voyez la petite parenthèse?
Shalom, Rabbi, shalom.
Shalom. He said, notes, bottom of the page, pay. Say, go and see what is written about Asaf Asifam. Meaning that what you say, Rabbi Carlos, we'll see if it is what he's saying here.
Okay,
on va voir ce que c'est ce que Rabbi Carlos said. This is ce qu'il dit ici. If is it something else, we're gonna see. So you go now on the right side of your book, not same page, on the right side of your book, right side. Yes, here. Asaf Asifam. Il dit c'est au-dessus. Donc c'est la photo que je vous ai envoyée. Commence en bas à droite.
That's why he's saying we already know.
No, it's saying no, not really. It's just on the top. Nahil, yeah. Just go back.
He's here and he's telling you we already know because he just said it 5 minutes.
Yes. You see, Asuf Asifam Naum.
Yeah.
Okay. Asuf Asifam Naum Adonai be En Anavim be Gefen be En Teinim. So what does it mean? The pasuk itself. You know what it means?
No.
It's in Yirmiyahu. Let's find it. Yirmiyahu chapter 8, pasuk yud gimel. Yirmiyahu chapter 8, pasuk yud gimel. Okay, read it in English.
Utterly destroy them, the word of Hashem. There will be no grapes on the vine and no figs on the fig tree. The leaf will live without, and what I have given to them will pass away.
In French, je suis décidé à en finir avec eux. À sauf à Sifar. It's not too hard.
No,
I will finish. Yeah. It's soft. Je vais en finir avec eux.
Not like yourself.
Not like yourself. Souvent ces femmes, je vais finir avec eux, dit Hachem. Il n'y a plus de raisin au vignoble, ni de figues au figuier. Les feuilles sont flétries. Ce que je leur avais donné passera en d'autres mains. You get it now? Is it Kafakela? Probably, maybe, but let's see. On va voir si c'est Kafakela, s'il est ou pas. Keep in mind, what to understand the link, the difference between Bitachon and Emuna. And why yesterday, the Zaken
brought us emuna through using the word arava. Pourquoi hier le Zaken nous a parlé de Mouna parlant des Aravot de Sukkot? So he says, "Asuasi fam, okay. Yomar al derer arimez besod a Gilgul ahu." So say, let's say about the Gilgul of that kind of person, kind of sounds. Regardons les Gilgulim de ce type d'avehu qui en avehi mitarem al nishmotem shel Israel shechatu, because the prophet here. He is really, really sad about the sons of the Israel who made sins. Le prophète ici se désole de l'âme des Juifs qui ont fait des fautes. Because of a sin, they were trapped inside of the klipot. À cause de leur faute, ils ont été attrapés dans la klipa. Ubetor adomem beatzomer beachay veenam medaber. Et voilà. We are in the Gavakela. Rabbi Kausa was right, but he said, "You see, we have to see always. If a yes, because of the sin, they are trapped in the minerals, in the vegetables, in the animals. Et à cause de Gilgulim, ils sont coincés dans le minéral, vegetal, animal. Kasher yadata besoda Gilgulim, besoda Gilgul, like you know about the Gilgul. Why say besoda Gilgul? He parle du secret de Gilgul because it's not the normal Gilgul of Sadikim." Et de Gilgul of Reshaim. Il dit parce que ce n'est pas des Gilgul des Sadikim, c'est des Reshaim. Ve Eshiv lo Akadosh Baruch Hu. And Hashem answered back to Yirmiyahu. Et Hashem lui a répondu. Ve Amar Esof Asifam Neum Azdel. I will finish with them. Je finirai avec eux. Quel Omar. Pour dire. Ani Haiti Rotse. Lo La Asof Anitsot Ou Amuvlaim Ebedomem Etsomea. Kede Le Ashkit Geulatam. He said, my desire at the beginning was not to finish with them. That's sort of what souls which are trapped in the minerals and the vegetables. My desire was to be helpful. Et mon désir, c'était de les aider. Ces âmes-là qui sont coincées dans le tsoméar, dans le végétal et le minéral. And to bring them out from the klipa. Et les emmener loin de la klipa. But I'm seeing now that they don't have any merit. So I don't understand. You have merit in the Kafakela?
So they can think about
Shiva. So how do you make it? Why is it in the Barada de la Mazé to only place on the Shiva?
It looks that even if they are conscious, it looks that they are powerless because they are trapped in there.
Mm-hmm.
They are expecting, their expectation is us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We release them from there.
So why he said they don't have schut? Said these people are going to eat them, smell them, weave them. Don't have schut. Why talk about them? Right. They're already trapped in the Kafakela. Pourquoi il dit qu'ils n'ont pas de mérite? Je ne sais pas, Kafakela, on peut avoir des mérites là-bas. Il dit que les gens qui doivent les libérer n'ont pas de mérite. Mais pourquoi eux? Et qui? Bavonotam, Sherabou, En... Anavim begefen ve'en atinim beteena ve'afilu al ein ve'al mitzad gilgul shel nefilat alim ki u gilgul yoter ra'a me'akulam. So he said, no, it's not like this. It's not comme ça. We are not in Kafakela yet.
What?
On n'est pas encore en Kafakela yet. So Rabbi Carlos, ta réponse était bonne, mais pas totalement. On est en train de construire.
D'accord.
It was good, but not totally. Good. He said that we are talking about people who even don't deserve Kafakela.
Oh.
On parle des gens qui ne méritent même pas le Kafakela. Pourquoi il dit? No figs, no grapes.
Ah.
Meaning that you cannot even not be your food, be food.
Oui, Pinchas.
Tu n'es même pas au niveau d'être un raisin. Et c'est even the worst gilgul of ever, which is to be a leaf gonna fall. You are not even the leaves are not.
You're so bad, Chas v'Shalom. You're so bad that even Kafakela is too high for you. Yeah, I start festival. I finish with them. Because all the system where you can be brought back, you cannot get. Gilgul Tzadik, you don't have. Geinam, you don't have. Gilgul Rasha, you don't have. Gilgul Rasha, meaning the leaves falling from the tree, you are not married to.
So they don't even have one mitzvah?
Let's see what the seed they did. Alors, quelle faute ils ont fait pour même pas avoir la possibilité d'être pris dans le Kafakela? And we're talking about Jewish souls. On parle des âmes juives. Gilgul Yeradam Yakol. Beit Galgel, Be'alim, Asher, Tedafa, Maroua. This is the worst Gilgul to be the leaf. C'est le pire Gilgul d'être une feuille. Parce que le roi, il fait ce qu'il veut de toi. Le roi, do what he wants with you. Veye, Ba'avonot, Mouchlar, Betit, ou Be'ramas, l'école d'Orer, Alav. Ve'advarim, Amukim. And he said, alors Rabbi David. And he said, Veye ba'avonot mushlar betit. And he said, because of their sin, they will be sent in the tit. What is tit? What is tit? Abbé Carlos, c'est quoi le titre?
Titre? Attends. Est-ce que c'est un truc en rapport avec le sol, genre de la boue, je sais pas quoi?
Ah, fait. Fait. It's like comme les mortiers. Mortar. Yeah.
What?
T'as envoyé dans les mortiers. What does it mean? C'est-à-dire quoi? Ou bavonot, mouchlar, betit, ou betit ve, mais betit ve, mais rames. What is me rames? I want to build with you because the things are very deep. I don't want to lose the introduction. If we lose the introduction, we will not understand everything that comes after.
Rabbi Pinchas, je t'aurais bien aidé. Une fois ça marchait, deux fois ça passe pas.
Rabbi Benjamin, what do you think? What is Miramis?
Yeah, we're trying to find
the word. Here. You have to keep your eyes and your finger on the text. Here.
Okay.
Is Miramis or is it Mirmas? What do you think? It's like Learos, Mirmas. It's to
smash.
Yeah, to crash. What do you do with mortar? Yeah. You want to make it. Yeah.
Combine.
Huh? Yeah, if you break them, c'est comme tu les écrases, tu les piétines. C'est un mirmas. So you said, I don't understand. You said that we don't have figs, we don't have grapes, we don't deserve a filou domaine, na'alim. And you said they finished like mortar, if it's comme de la mortier qu'on piétine. This is a Gilgul. So what does it mean? Ça veut dire quoi? What's the problem? What was their sins? C'est quoi leur faute? To say that, you know what? You made something wrong. Vous avez fait quelque chose de bizarre. Regardez maintenant. On l'école de rare à lave. V'advarim amokim. Rien qu'à l'autre, c'est things are deep here. Choses sont profondes, attention. Ou biot, qui dvarim elu em, que בושנו של העולם. לזה החי ייתן אל ליבו. He said, this these things are like the shame of the world. Ces choses sont comme la boucha, c'est comme la tiens, boucha, bouchnou, bouchnou chez la hola. The shame of the world, c'est l'honte, la honte du monde. And it's the people who are alive, les gens qui sont vivants, have to pay attention about what we're going to say now. Les gens doivent faire attention à ce qu'on va dire maintenant. Mais où? Here is. Qui? Atzmachim ve'anifashot muvla'im betocham lo asu peri. C'est because the vegetals and the salts trapped inside of them, they don't create fruits. What does it mean? Ça veut dire quoi que les végétales et les âmes pensées là-bas n'ont pas fait de fruits? Kedesh sheyeh mukhan le'achilat adam, in order to be ready to be eaten by the man, pour être prêt à manger par l'homme. Ve'yaviu l'idée tikkun ochel nefesh. And by being eaten, they will be fixed. And the moment sera fixé. Ve'al yedeze yuchlu la'alot le'madrigat Adam. And thank this, by being eaten, they could achieve the level of man, being inside of the man. And the moment sera refusé, je repète au niveau des hommes. Ve'zehu shama ve'eten la'em yavroum. On sait le ma, qui yavor tor gouf, akerouv aleem. Des sodes. Oh dodo oh oh ben dodo oh yigarenu. So it's basically the purpose, like we saw, like we know from the Kafakela, is to give you an open window to come back in food by being eating and to introduce to enter the Gehinom after. So you have to play a role. What's your role? Being able to be what I can eat you. If you are not something can be eaten. What happened? Something wrong. So don't think that all the vegetables, all the fruits which are not comestible, which are not cannot be eaten, it's because God decided like that. It seems to be that the good gilgul have to be able to be eaten. There are some fruit you see them go in the forest. I don't eat that. I don't eat that. It's dangerous. Why? When that this gilgul here, something is wrong with him. Meaning, if you are punished in Kafakela to go in Gilgul of Tzomea, you have to make kind of teshuva. Where is it? Maybe before you die. But this will give you the possibility to create fruits, being a Tzomea. Il dit, non, qu'est-ce qui se passe quand tu es condamné pour aller au Kafakela et que tu es condamné à être une dimension de Gilgul dans les végétales? Il faut que tu puisses faire des fruits. Sinon, tu as raté ton gilgul. Mais à quel moment tu sais que tu as raté ou pas? C'est en faisant peut-être quelque chose avant de mourir. C'est quoi? On ne sait pas encore. Look now what he said. Obioto ki en la em schout la tchet misham. Ki en anavim begefen ve en tenim betena. This is another explanation of the pasuk of Yirmiyahu. He said, because you don't have schout to go out from the kafakela, you don't bring any fruit. Without fruits, you cannot be eaten. Parce que tu n'as pas de mérite, bah tu es coincé dans un gilgul végétal qui ne donne pas de fruits. That's why he said, no grapes on the vineyard and no figs on the fig tree. C'est-à-dire qu'il dit, il n'y a pas de grappe sur la vigne et il n'y a pas de figues dans le figuier. And even the leaves are not there. Et même les feuilles ne sont pas là. So what does it mean? It's like a tree totally dry. C'est comme un arbre desséché. Now you can connect also why the moment we have to come back in Israel is connected to the food suddenly starting to come out from the land and from the
house.
Yeah,
because even a leaf,
all the
skulls are waking up.
Yeah.
Because even a leaf, like some
insects
eat the leaves.
Yes. A leaf on a tree, you have to cry by, so because you're so happy. voir une feuille sur un arbre séché, il faut commencer à être heureux. Sometimes we don't pay attention, we work here, you see a leaf comes out from the middle of the beton. You have to sit down and start to think. So, wow, Hashem, ma rabu ma asera. How amazing are your actions? Let me spend it right here. Leaves sometimes come out from the wall. It's a miracle.
Yeah, if you go up here on Jaffa out the gate, look at the wall. I believe there's a fig tree growing out of the wall.
Yeah.
If you go up by Jaffa, you'll see. I looked at it every day. I can see it, obviously. You're looking. I believe it. No. It's like after the, it's in this big section where the grass is. On the main street.
Donc voir de l'herbe, une feuille verte sortir d'un béton, c'est un miracle. So now pay attention about the cotel. Remarquez le cotel. The wall is here. Where you come out from all the leaves that are here? So it means a lot of things. It's not normal things. It's not natural.
It's a big stuff. On the other side that you face down from our
We still don't know what the problem. Donc c'est toujours pas c'est quoi le problème. Look, regardez. Ou bien toi qui aime la end route, ok. Mitramim hem yomrim alma anachnu yoshvim ve'asafnu im nochad ve'ze yomrim yesh el re'u. ואיש אל ריחו, ובזה נבוא אל הרעי המבצר, והם גופי הצדיקים, להיות להם אוכל, נפש ומזון, ובזה נתקן ונוכל לדמות אליו. So he said basically, when you are in the gilgul of vegetals, continue on the gilgul of the vegetal, your purpose is to bring out food. Ton but c'est de sortir des fruits. Why? Like this, the tzaddik can eat you. Comme ça, le tzaddik peut te manger. And you and him become one. Et toi, et vous devenez un. Why? The food goes in the blood. Parce que la nourriture va dans le sang. So, Adam ou à Adam. The blood is the man. So, we will be like them. That's why he said, Bazé, nitaken, menucha, leidamot, elav. By being eaten by tzaddik, we will be fixed and we will be like him. You see how good, how pity of Hashem is. You are a rasha gamur. You are the kafakela. Just by being eaten, you become a tzaddik like the tzaddik.
Now we learn you need the miracle. Otherwise, forget it. You're not going to eat them back.
Yes.
I don't know.
Huh? I hope I will never know.
Maybe they're just so happy that they don't care about things, but they're like, yeah, it's finally happening. I've been waiting on this tree for like 20 years, and now finally someone's.
So look what they said. Oh, your mom, your friend, or let's see something else. The Uki, Shirau, Elu, Amuvole, Betomea, Ki, En, La, Em, Takana. So now it's a let's see different the story in a different way. Well, only story in a manner different. That's all which are trapped in the tzomea. C'est ça qui sont dans le tzomea, dans le végétal. When they saw that there's no hope, they try to bring out fruit, nothing comes out. What does it mean? No merit from your previous life. Vous êtes donné des fruits, il n'y a pas de mérite de la présente vie, il n'y a rien qui sort. Ou biot qui en anavin begefen. So don't think we don't have grapes in the vineyard. So they start to complain to each other. Ils commencent à se complaindre les uns des autres. Ve'omrim alma anachnu yoshvim. Wow, are we here? You're down, we're trapped. On est coincé là. Pirouche explanation. Ki en lanu takana. We don't have hope. We don't have tikkun. On n'a pas d'espoir. On n'a pas de tikkun. Ve'anachnu yirim lavo. Ve'madrigat yoteir tartona mize. It's because we missed up in the level of Tzomea, we don't give food,
We have to go in the lower level. What is to be a mortar? Devenir du mortier. And we work on you. Et on marche sur toi. So meaning that we want to focus on the Gilgul of the Tzomeach. On veut se focaliser sur le Gilgul of Tzomeach. What say yesterday the Zohar? Haimuna connected to Aravot of Sukkot. Oh, why? Why Bitachon Emuna Aravot? I remind you, we have to see the difference between Bitachon and Emuna. So it's simply that Emuna is connected in a way to Tzomeach. You said Aravot, yes. On a vu Emuna c'est relié à Aravot, donc Emuna c'est lié à Tzomeach. So he said, now because you missed it, you don't bring fruit, and pas de fruit, you have to go in the lower level, meaning domain. Tu dois aller dans le niveau le plus bas. Till now, we only knew that the Gilgulim goes up. We said that people have to pass from here to here to here. Remember, you have to go from domain, to Mea, Chaim et Daber. On a toujours vu que les Gilgulim sont à Bakeda. Tu vas de bas en haut, en étant dans la dimension de domain, to Mea, Chaim et Daber. Now you see that you can lose also your status. You can go down. Tu peux aller plus bas. C'est pas toujours par le haut. Tu peux passer de végétal à minéral. You can go from Tzomea to domaine. Like said the Nigerian. Rabbi Okuma, you're here?
Well, that makes sense. Yes. Harav, I'm here. Shalom.
Shalom. Like you said, Nigeria.
even in like practicality that happens, it falls to the ground.
Yeah.
And then it deteriorates.
Yes, yes.
And it goes into the ground.
Exactly.
But the animal dies and it's eaten by
Let's see. We are getting something. On avance the athlete. We move slowly, slowly. I don't want to miss any single step. Because after it's going to be very hard. C'est pour ça que je vais aller doucement, je ne vais pas manquer un seul état, parce que après ça va être un peu dur. So he said, Où bevoanu sham, yamrulan ou amekatregim, ve'asfu, ou baou al ar'e mifsa, betor avne kir, ou betzorot bebet asade, be'em adomem, komon eval. So he said, what's happened? When we've been losing our status now, we are in vegetals, we fall in domain. What will tell, well, what the accusators will say about us? Look at them. They fall, let get them, and there will be the walls of the house, the walls in the field, there will be the houses. This is the highest or the worst punishment. Le niveau le plus bas, tu as raté le tirmeur, tu tombes là-bas. Chez Neymar à la Havre, Bayamut, Libo, Bekirbo. Il dit, this is why this pasuk has been written. C'est le pasuk qui a été écrit. And his heart will die inside of him. Son cœur va mourir à l'intérieur de lui. Meaning that you pass from tirmeur to domain. Tu es passé de végétal à domain. You're done. It will be a stone. Oh, even. So what's even Ashtiya? I don't understand. Alors, je comprends pas. C'est quoi la pierre qui nourrit tout le monde avec de l'eau? It's minerals. C'est domaine. Who is there? Alors, qui est là? Benashtiya, the stone which filled all the world with waters. So who is inside? The worst of the worst? Look, regarde.
That's why they didn't get Sahara. They stole the Sahara, they didn't get punished for it. Hashem's like, don't worry. You can be a stone in a house and you still get punished for it.
Wow. Mais c'est quand ce qui est écrit. This is what is written. Chez Nidme Sham, la chaîne Domem. C'est one, the pasuk c'est Nidme. C'est Nidme, it's like Domem, it's the same letters. They become a stone, ils deviennent des pierres. To become a stone is a gzera from your creator. Devenir une pierre, c'est une gzera. C'est un décret négatif contre de ton créateur. Because basically, he will put us at that level because we sin against him. Put us upside down. Nous a mis de haut en bas. Yeshkenu Merosh. Keep this expression. Yeshkenu Merosh. We will see what it means in a few minutes. Kichatan, parce qu'on a fauté. Mais c'est chose, mais c'est qu'à tout, bien qu'en. Kavé le shalom, ve en tov, le et, makpe, ve ou, ve ata'a. Et c'est ça aussi ce qui a été dit. Ils espéraient avoir le shalom, ils n'ont même pas trouvé du tov. They were targeting to find shalom, but even find any single thing good. וזהו גם כן מה שכתוב, הבאה כצעיר, כלאה כקיץ, ואנחנו לא נושענו, לרמוז על מה שאמר הרב זעל, שיש גלגול בדלת זמנים בשנה. כל גימל חודשים ביסוד אחד מגלגלים הנשמות, להתקן שם, ולעלות מדרגה אל מדרגה. כל אחד כפי מעשיו וכפי זמן הכתוב עליו, וכפר על עוון השיח הטאבו, ככתוב בגלגולים בעורר. עד כאן, אם כן, אתה מתרעים אלו ואומרים, כי ביות ואין הנביאים בגפן, זאת היא הסיבה שיעבור כציר וציץ. וכל י' ב' חודשים השנה, ולא נושעו בעוונותם. ובזה יובן גם כן מה שכתוב, הנה לצופעם. ובחנתם רוצה לומר, הייתי רוצה לצורפם ולביאם למקום קדוש, ואיני יכול מפני רעת בת עמי. בגילוי זה העניין, רמז בפסוק אחרון, באומרו דבר כה נאום אדוני ונופעל מבלעת האדם. יאמר ביות שהגזירת אמת, שיפול לבלעת האדם כדומם. על פי השדה רוצה לומר, כאבן דומם, ומאה שהיו בצומע היו כאמיר מחרי הקוצר, ואין מאסף אותו הביתה, להביאם לידי תיקון, ולא יוכל להתבטל לגזירה. כן נאמר, כן אמר, וזאת התעלל ומתעלל, שהשכל ידוע וצעי, ויגיעי, מאיתה בכלפי חסד, וזה סוד כאמר, וזאת התעלל וכו', כי אני אדוני עושה חסד וכו', יען תשלום רוש זה בפסוק ונתתי עשה בשדך. אוקיי, make it short, all the final part, what we already know, he's talking about every single גלגול כבקלה, they move from part to part, according to the month of the years. The purpose is not to go there, but we get it. What Rabbi Karo said is right. Donc, le but, après la fin de ce pasuk, il explique les liens qu'il y a entre les différents gilgulim et les temps de l'année, les 12 mois. Mais on ne va pas rentrer là-bas. Donc, ce que Rabbi Karo avait dit, c'était ça. So, what is the question here about the gilgul of Tzomear and Domem? It's all the story of Kafakela. So now we close the bracket, we go back in our original text. Now on ferme la parenthèse, on repart dans le texte original. What he said in the original text, we want to understand why is cursed the man who gives his trust to a man? Ah, you see where we're going now? Exactly. Exact. Qu'est-ce qui se passe ici? Pourquoi le passage qu'on est là, il y a marqué « Maudit soit l'homme qui met sa confiance en l'homme ». Ça veut dire qu'en fait, c'est ça le problème ici. C'est ce qui fait que, chas et shalom, tu passes un gilgul, le gavakela, tu n'as même pas la possibilité d'amener des fruits. This is the reason why. You give your trust to a man, chas et shalom, you go to gavakela, you will be unable to bring out fruits. This is the problem. Arur. What is Arur? It's not only now. Now and after. Like he said something very deep, Rabbi David. If you give your trust to a man, see to that conversation, who are you? Animal. You see? You said it. You see? If you give your trust to Hashem, who are you? Man. If you give your trust to a man, who are you? Animal. So when you die, you go to Tzomeach, vegetables.
Ah, ça nous fait descendre.
C'est ça la malédiction. C'est ça la malédiction. Tu donnes ta confiance à Dieu, tu es un homme. Tu donnes ta confiance à un homme, tu es un animal. Donc, en fait, quand tu es vécu comme un animal, tu meurs, tu vas où? Au niveau.
Oui, en dessous.
Et tu n'auras pas de fruits. But you will not give fruit. So what happened to you? You finish. No man. Just because you gave your trust to a man. Who said that? Irmiahu. Arur al-gever asher ifta ba'adam. Maudit soit l'homme qui donne sa confiance à l'homme. Curse be the man who gives his trust to the man. To a man. Look at what he said. This one. It's a man. I know. To me, I'm going to say. She Asher esir bitroneo bimekom. So what happens, Rabbi Shmuel? The Rasha who remove his trust from Hashem. You see? Bitachon, pas de bitachon. Celui qui enlève sa confiance en Dieu. You don't trust in Hashem. You trust in men. Tu crois aux hommes. Mais noten bitroneo bebasar adam kemou. And give his trust to a man done with flesh and blood. Qui donne sa confiance à un homme qui est fait de chair et de sang. You see? Amar al-Av, c'est on show ou sheye ke arara. He said, the pasuk said, your punishment will be that you will be like a dry Arava. Tu seras, ta punition sera comme, tu seras comme une Arava sans fruits, sans production, on va dire. Ni couleur, ni odeur, ni rien. Quand c'est l'Omar, Ra, Ra. Et c'est Lucas de Pasouk, the second line. Just after the Pasouk, where now it's written, where it's written, you design. Here. You see, here. What the pasuk said, veye ke ara, sorry. You see, second line, just here. He said, don't say ara, it's two times ra. Ra, ra. Et ne dis pas ara, ara. I will share the screen with you. Je crois avec vous. Look. One second. Dites-moi que tu vois mon écran. Let me know if you see my screen.
C'est bon.
C'est donc c'est Arar, ne dites pas Arar. Non, sorry. Excuse-moi, c'est pas celui-là. Je ne vous ai pas envoyé la photo du texte que j'ai lu avant, n'est-ce pas?
Attends, il me semble que. Non. Si, si. C'est quoi la page? C'est. Ta view de Dalet?
Ah si, vous avez reçu. Alors, elle est où la page? Je n'ai pas envoyé la page.
Elle est juste au-dessus, en fait.
Ah, voilà. Say, you say, don't say ara. Okay, ara. C'est rotelema ra two times. Ra deux fois on the top left. Don't say ara, it's two times ra. You say it, Fabien Khanan? You have it? Don't say. Okay, ara. C'est rotelema ra two times. And he said, what is ra two time, gematria, zera. You get it?
One ra is
zain. Ra is
ra, ra. One of the ra's turns to a zain, zera.
I don't know how you make it.
Zero.
Not Rava, so Arava, it's Zera.
Ah,
Arava, Gematria, Zera. Like you saw yesterday. On l'a vu hier. Arava, Gematria, Zera. So what is two times Ra? It's Zera, because you know that Ra is Zera Nematala. And say Er Ayara. Son of Yehuda, it was Ra. Losing seeds. So when you have two times Ra, it all according to Zera. So what does it mean? What is the correlation? You're talking about Bitachon. I understand that bitachon, putting my faith to a man, bring me to be le shalom, so mea, okay. I now bring zera by using arava. What I mean to the zera, maintenant to arava, so je pouvais comprendre que mon manque de bitachon, je donne ça à un homme, et okay, mais why bring zera? Look, on se l'oma, ra, ra. Ve arava, et le mot arava, le sol pleureur, and the arava, of the lulav, gematria zera, veiye ba'aret milcha, milcha shelo ta'ase perot. So you say what's happened? You will bring down in the earth something which that creates fruit. What is zera levatala? Yeah, you bring something out. We have something called land. No fruit comes. Mida keneged mida.
Right,
the children are free from that. Yes. So, c'est quoi, tu amènes quelque chose par terre, mais rien ne sort. Donc, mida, kada, mida, tu seras un semeur qui ne sort pas de fruits. You will be a semeur without food. So, what is the origin or the consequence? It's sometimes the same of a man giving his trust to another man. C'est quoi la conséquence ou l'origine d'un homme qui donne sa confiance à un homme? Non, c'est l'origine ou la conséquence.
Ah,
non,
c'est l'acte de confiance.
Non,
c'est l'acte de confiance.
L'original consequence.
The original and the consequence. The original and the consequence. It's a cycle. Once you start to have the alevatala, the whole story. Because in Marshava, you decide to bring it down to give it out. Donc, dès que tu fais Zera Levatala, ton bitachon il est mort. Your bitachon is done. If your bitachon is done, you are arur, you are cursed. Tu es maudit. What is the next stage, Rabbi Shalom? To be a tzomeyar, who will be without fruit? Tu seras un tzomeyar sans fruit. And this is also for women. So c'est pour les femmes, because women also, they have zera levatala.
So that was the same that they did, but he said no meats, no vines, no grapes, and no
things. No, the sin was bitachon.
Which made them do the zera levatala, which made them stop.
Exactly. Cycle.
Cycle is no bitachon, zera levatala.
Yeah, cycle is no bitachon, zera levatala, or zera levatala, no bitachon. It's like the chicken and the eggs and the chicken. And after cursed, because you say arur, give Hashem tabadonai, Hashem, ba Adam, you're cursed. What's that curse? You go to Kafakela,
Kafakela is the last stage where you can be saved when you are Asha. Even there, you are not saved because you miss fruits. You don't give something good. Why? Because being alive, you waste it. You see why the Zohar yesterday was so hard to understand? Pourquoi le Zohar d'hier était très dur à comprendre? Because he was coding all this. We talk about Arava, we talk about Even, we talk about waters, we talk about Emuna, we talk about Sukkot. Where is going? Et Baruch Hashem, Rakadosh is here. Let's make it. Vas-y. C'est pour ça que le Zohar d'hier était compliqué à comprendre. Il fallait passer par là. You have to pass through there. Sometimes you have to have some nimut when you say, you know what, the Torah is too high. You need that sometimes. And after, you find the text and you make it one. Donc il faut des fois passer par là. And he said, You see, you're trapped in the Kafakela forever. On a vu que normalement Kafakela, it's a cycle, c'est un cycle. You pass domain, Somea, Chaime Daber, Gainan, Ganeden. Okay. He said no. If you want that situation, you're trapped forever. Situation of being found without food. Situation de trouver sans fruit. Et ça. Mais là, il y a le haut. Il louille, mais de même, les tomates à cacher et data. Omnam, à beauté à Hashem. But this one who gives his bitachon to Hashem. Celui qui donne sa bitachon à Hashem. Chesed, il s'en va et il traîne nous. Chesed is surrounding him. Le chesed l'entoure. You remember you saw Yuval yesterday also in the Zohar. Pasuk with Yuval. The same pasuk. La lot min amadriga el amadriga. So if you are, let's say, you give your trust to Hashem, you missed up. Chazal shalom. But the chesed that you have will bring you to Kafakela in the Aliyah direction, not the Yehida. Et parce que tu vas mettre ta confiance à Dieu, même dans le Kafakela, le cycle que tu vas entamer, ça sera de bas vers le haut. We'll go from the Mem, Somea, Chai, et Daber. This is the chesed. If not, Madriga, ou בישנת שצורת כלומר אפלפי שתבואו נפשו במצור ובמצות מתגלגל שאין צדיק בארץ אשר יעשה טוב ולא יחטא אם כל זה יהיה מתגלגל באילן העושה פירות. So say meaning that you will just because of that, even if you are missing things, you will be a tree giving fruit. Meaning someone will come, take the fruit of I will make a blessing, and you will be fixed. You give fruit, tu donneras des fruits, même si tu as un gilgul dans le soméa, tu seras un arbre fruitier. That's why we are specific halachot about the tree giving fruit. That's why it's forbidden to remove the roots of a tree giving fruit. It's asur.
Why we have to wait 3 years
before we can
eat
there? Yeah, also. If you just eat them straight away, they don't want to. No, they're not ready yet.
Because you're taking away the opportunity for
Hashem
to provide fruit
for the Sadiq. Exactly. Basically, also, the Rasha succeed to build good action merit, and you remove all the merit he was giving. So you can see, even non-Jews says, this tree is amazing. Every year we have amazing bananas. Amazing food, and you wait to give the next year. It's all work. On voit très bien même les non-juifs, ils ont cette notion que l'arbre là il donne des fruits extraordinaires. Amazing orange. We know, on sait que cet arbre là, chaque génération, chaque cycle donne. We know that that tree, every cycle gives amazing fruit. See, this has to stand. It's the sign that you have a tzaddik, you have a kafakela souls, Jewish souls, but he had merit. He gave something.
So
So then why do we say that only a tzaddik can have Gilgul? Anyone can have Gilgul, or they need
No, there's two kinds of Gilgul. There's a Gilgul of tzaddikim and Gilgul of Keshayim. You know, because tzaddikim, you always go man. Wow. One day you are one generation, you are Levi, you are Cohen, after you will be this. But you are always there. You never go to the level of animals. And so this is for the Kafakin.
Yeah. It's for the those who go to Kafakela.
Nefesh Sikhli.
Do they have got Nefesh Sikhli also, or they did lose it completely?
Nefesh Sikhli would not be far with Kafakela. Nefesh Sikhli, yes. Okay. It's finished, this first part. On a cette partie. Payavo Toda. Payavo l'idée est tikkun à l'idée au chen nefesh. And by being eaten, we are the tikkun. On est en mode de voir leur tikkun. Velo yidag, velo yamouch, ma'asot perila, l'od, mi madriga, el madriga, yot adam. And they will have always hope to go. Step after step, il aura toujours l'espoir d'aller étape après étape pour devenir nimo homme, après le guénome être préparé. Mais Zéchamar, c'est ce qui est écrit, parce que tu as dit, Ami Hachem, Hoker lève, Ami Hachem, and I check the heart. I know what's happening inside, je vérifie les cœurs. Mais la tête, les ish, qui est d'arcave, qui est péri, mais allez lave. I will give to each one according to what I saw in the heart. Yeah. Akira. So here is the first level between Bitachon and Emunah. We saw that at Pesach, Waka Pesach, with the Sfirat HaOmer, with the Seder, what we do, qu'est-ce qu'on fait? Elokim Ardata. We make sweeter the Gvorot of that. And once we've done that, HaKadosh said, we have built the Bitachon. On a construit Bitachon. That's why all the sages of Kabbalah, that's why the sages of Kabbalah to this, if you want a successful year, don't miss the 50 days between Pesach and Shavuot. Tu veux une année réussie, ne manque pas les 50 jours entre Pesach et Shavuot. Why? Because you build the Bitachon there.
Mais Rabbi Pinch.
Oui.
Ah, pardon. J'allais te dire, mais en fait, ça n'a aucun sens de commencer l'année à Tishri.
I said that so if it's like this, no sense to start the year in Tishri. Yes. Why are we starting Tishri?
Tu veux construire quoi ta Emouna sans avoir fait de Bitachon? Ça sert à rien.
That's it. On va essayer de construire. On va essayer de comprendre. When is the world judged? Quand le monde est jugé?
Rosh Hashanah.
Rosh Hashanah. You agree?
What do you say?
What do you mean? The sun, Shvat, Tishrei. You talking about the Rosh Hashanah or the
judgment? Okay.
When the world is judged, quand le monde est jugé. Rosh Hashanah, we have four Rosh Hashanah, yes. But the judgment.
The Sim, Hanukkah,
Here's the situation. It's written that all the world is judged at Rosh Hashanah. But why, si tout le monde est déjà Rosh Hashanah, why you say that at Kippour, you have another judgment? Who is judged at Kippour? Qui est jugé à Kippour? No, Benoni.
Oh yeah, it's something.
Rosh Hashanah, you think?
Let's see.
Rosh Hashanah Rava is judged. Reshaim. You have to help them. Even if you are trapped in the domain. Même si tu es coincé dans le domaine, meaning that you were a tomea without fruit. We know what finished with you. You already become domain. That's why we take the tomea, So you know what? Come back. A bit below Khatib. Ah, why? Like me to bring him back, bring him up. That's a stone, it's already fixed. It takes a shape and it's standing in some in a place. But this one is just dust outside. So look. Reshaim, ils sont jugés à Roshana Rabba. Reshaim va dire à Roshana Rabba. Benonim va judge on Kippur. Benonim, c'est déjà Kippur. You said Tzadikim, they are judged at Rosh Hashanah. Is there another judgment in the year? Toda! When are the king judged? Son! So who are you? Where are you standing?
Oh, you're asking him for kings or for
all the tzaddikim amiti, we are not judged with the tzaddikim Rosh Hashanah, they are judged with the kings of the world. What do you think they are?
They are
the kings. What's happened during the Nissan time? You count the kings. Sfirat HaOmer, seven kings. Because you have not to the Sfirat HaOmer, you count les rois. So your judgment is will be there. Rosh Hashanah, like said the Mikubalim, for you, it will always be between two Sfirat HaOmer. It's nothing. It's like the year is done. What is to judge something in the middle of the year? If my years is from Nissan to Nissan, what is Rosh Hashanah for me? Nothing. Just a checkpoint. Of my way. If not, I go back where I came, but I go back to Nissan. But will not block me. This is the choice to live from Nissan to Nissan. C'est le choix d'habiter de Nissan à Nissan. Parce qu'à ce moment-là, Rosh Hashanah is not standing in the top or in the beginning. It's not in the middle. It's like you have already start your year, you are, when Rosh Hashanah come, you get it.
That's why it's half holiday.
Yes.
Part judgment, but part exactly.
Because what Hashem was hoping, because Hashem he voulait en fait, is that you make your tshuva from Nissan. And from Nissan, you are going like this. Zaki v'lo Hashem. But what's happened? It's how I get you. I tell you, Zahu. He put to you 2 months of holidays. What you did? You close the Siddur Yeshiva. Holidays. Remove your kippah. Beach. Tanning. Yes. Okay. Wash your hands, please. You don't understand how it's happened? It's like Aliyah. It's coming Aliyah. Il vous fait partir de Nissan, Teshuvah, Pesah, Sfirat HaOmer, Sfirat HaOmer, Shavuot, now you have strength, okay. Go and fight for me, Tammuz and Av. You go, you fight them. And when you fight them, what's happened? Elul and Tishri. Check, check. A lot of people do, they make a big afsaka at the worst moment. Not that people do. I know how to bring to the guy the good desire to make the Jewish, to bring the Jewish far away from the Kedusha. Why the holidays are not in the, let's say, in March? Well, put them when it's hot, you know, when you have the sun. Go! Chofesh! What is Chofesh? You have Chofesh? You have Chofesh, bro? It's Aliyah. That's why you will see most of the people trapped in Rosh Hashanah, there are people who enjoy the holidays. You know what you did. That's why Rosh Hashanah, you have to start slichot. Why you start slichot like that? Why you scream so hard? Why you need the shofar every day? We know what you did.
During Nisan.
No, during the shofar. Elul. Why do they put
you? You didn't work so hard on Nisan.
Yes.
You were being... Not you, the person who's being sinful, so I have
to now put a slick
off. Exactly. Because the person's always working through Nisan. But then the work of fighting Tammuz and Av, by the time you get to Rosh Hashanah, Elul,
check, check.
You're saying, wow, this is the best time of the king's in the field, and the surrounding, and the world is getting judged because of the work that the Sadiqim did.
Exactly. Regardez en tête.
The Sadiqim can pray to Hashem during Rosh Hashanah saying,
yes.
Get rid of these kings, these evil kings, these bad guys. What am I trying to do?
Exactly.
It's my fight for it. You're not going to judge
exactly.
Because we understood already the Gemara that the king of the world are judged on Nisan. What all of us think? Trump, Obama. No, we're the king of the world. Tzadikim and Mitzvim. They want.
And the seven other kings.
Yes.
Of Moab and Ammon.
Oh, even then they are under, because they just know how to play on the weakness of our people. But they are not this kind of king who can say, you know what?
So they'll be judged on Rosh Hashanah.
Yes. We're talking about the kings, you know, that kind of king, or part of the Sewarak, you say, you know what, Hashem, I'm the king of that people. Give to me. It's my people. They did that because I said that. It's the real king. This one who goes in the battlefield, he's telling one of his people. This is the real king. C'est le vrai roi. Nous, on dit que les rois sont jugés à Nissan, on pense qu'on parle des rois du monde. No. The tzadikim and mitzvim, they are the real kings. With the crown of the Torah. They came, even the Trump, they beg them, please pray that America will not be. Yeah, they pray. Vous avez compris? You get it?
Oui, oui.
Yes. Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
The kings of what?
Oh, it's written in the Gemara that in Nisan the kings of the world are judged.
Okay.
So are the Obama, all the kings. Right? Okay. Like these have been taught, no?
Yes.
But it's false. All the king of the world.
All. No, I did not get that.
Who are the kings of the world?
Yes,
Tzadikim, not this one who have been elected.
Okay.
So when they are judged in Nisan, so they are not judged at Rosh Hashanah. They don't come Rosh Hashanah with
fear. There's no double jeopardy here. You can't
try twice. Vous avez compris?
Oui.
You get it, Rabbi Nathan Hanan, or you need more explanation?
Yeah. That's it. King Shlomo said it's at the key of the foundation of the world.
Yes.
Does it refer to, this king to refer to this, it's at the king?
A real king is someone who carry on his shoulder something. If you're a king for yourself or for your money, how much you're a king for? Let's see now a small thing before we go in the hardest part. On voit un petit texte maintenant avant qu'on accélère, on voit la partie la plus dure. C'est faire l'écoutim always. Daf Resh Ein He. We start in the bottom of Dalet, but it's mainly in a Shanghai. Just a few lines.
Some of this makes, well, I can only speak for me, makes me feel hopeless. Like, if they've ever done the no more bitachon, and you're going to have a kela, and it's like this idea of shufa. I know I'm not supposed to give up hope, but learning some of this, it kind of feels sad.
It's the real fear you need to feel if you want to make a real tshuva. Because there are solutions. There are solutions.
C'est bon, on a reçu.
On a reçu?
Oui.
I will start from the last line on the page Resha in Dalet. Gamken, you see, Gimel Kaf.
Gamken, c'est bon, vous voyez Gamken? Gamken, a man shenitan Israel. So the manna which was given to Israel, the man that we ate in the desert. La manna qui a été donnée à Israël. La midbar d'Ordea, in the desert of Dordea, dans le désert, quand il y a the generation of knowledge, la génération de la connaissance. Al-Yede Moshe Rabbeinu, thanks to Moshe Rabbeinu, Shenishmat'u Mimakom Adat, who had his soul from the level of, from the place of that, qui avait son âme, origine du dat, originaire du dat. Eze, ou Shenirman, du Pasuk, Ve Aman, Kezera, Gad. Sophet Evot, Eden, Sheou, Makom, Makomam, Ve Even. He said, you take the Pasuk, Ve Aman, Kezera, Gad. Rachet Evot, Sophet Evot, you have Ve Aman, Nun, Kezera, Ain. God Dalet, we have the word Eden, Gan Eden, to tell us the origin from the man. Raven, so you have to understand. Donc, il dit, on voit ici dans les rachetés votes des mots utilisés, le mot Eden apparaît, l'origine de la man. Kimisham, aya yored aman, because the man was coming from the Eden, Gan Eden. La man est venu du Gan Eden. Mimakom amor shel machshava, from the place of the brain of machshava.
So is that why the mind tastes like anything you want in your face?
Yes. It comes from machshava. Machshava. Donc la main vient de la machshava. Mimakom elyon. Say, what is, where is it exactly? You say, you know that on the head of Ari, you have 7 tikkunim. You have 7 tikkunim. Like you have 13 tikkunim in his beard, you have 7 in his head. This is the 7, what did they not? 7 dread that Shimshon had. You know, he had 7. Yeah. Okay, the man comes from one of the 7 places here of Arir. Donc, la man vient d'une des 7 places des tikkunim des cheveux de Arir. Kaniska Bedrushim, like we said in Ezraim, comme c'est écrit dans Ezraim. Ve'u Arosh Shenit Mal'e Tal. This is the head that receives all the dew. C'est la tête qui reçoit toute la rosée. Ki ou achdut shalem, avaya echad. Because this is the place of unity. C'est la place de l'union. Ah, what did we say yesterday? That aravot, they are netzahot. And we asked, what the connection to netzahot, where do you bring it to be called echad? And then when I saw Rabbi Yosha, he said, no, because Netzahot, they are usually one. And when you take one, you have Echad, and Echad is Vem Emuna. Here is. Donc, on avait vu hier, en fait, pourquoi la Emuna is two things. Pourquoi la Emuna, c'est deux Aravot. Yes. Exactly. So, meaning that all the Emuna is one. La Emuna, c'est d'être un. Shalom, Rabbi Brandon.
Shalom, shalom.
Shalom. C'est-à-dire que la Emouna, c'est un. Même si on parle de deux Aravot, mais ça odd, mais ça odd, they are one.
So we know that
with Moshe
and Aaron.
Yeah?
Moshe and Aaron are one.
Yes, but it seems to me that the man was coming only on the merit of Moshe. Aaron, it was the Ananik Avot. Again, it was the well.
No, but the idea of Hod and Netzach being one is that Aaron and they're considered equal in parts, and they got
a Nuna. It's a I see what you mean, and you can't
midrash like that, but it's hard to find place where they are called one Moshe Nehara. Always you see.
I think the midrash talks about how sometimes
there's a switch. Yeah.
Moshe is first and Aaron's second.
Yes.
Aaron's first and
Moshe. Yes, but it's hard to find a place where they say they are echad.
Yeah.
Like Nadav and Avihu, we find place they say they are one. So, but the drush, if you consider drush.
I just wanted to say,
drush
and Aaron. No, because also because they brought Emunah to the people.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Well, man and mine have the same material.
Yeah.
Whoa.
They say, because you read, I'll be. Sorry. Tan, Vehu, Ahdut, Shalem. So they are one. C'est le Echad. Ils sont une unité là-bas. In the head. Et Yored al Zaken Dikne Dikna. Derrière. And after the, it goes on the beard of Ariel. Après, ça descend de la tête, from the head to the beard of Ariel. Ou Misham, le Zaken Aaron, Dikna Deza. From that place, it goes to the beard of Aaron. We have the oil coming from the beard of Aaron, it's an image. But from Aaron, basically, is the third place, the head of Ariel, the beard of Ariel, and the beard of Aaron. So all this tal, all this shefa comes down like this. It's not comme ça. Ve'az yored al pi midotav ket al chermon ve'yored al achare tion, achare tion. She'em netzar od. And then after, from the beard of Aaron, it goes down and it goes on the mountains of Zion. What are them? Netzarot, the two Aravot. Look. C'est les Netzarot, les deux Aravot. You have too many mountains here. You have to find two. The two mountains of Zion here, it's Netzarot from the Yisrael of Luke.
So it's like the spiritual
numbers. Yes, physical also, but to know which one is Netzah, or maybe it's Arazetim and Arabite, but not sure. You have kind of. No, I've seen
doesn't
it.
Doesn't it say Hermon here?
Huh?
Doesn't it say mountains of Hermon?
No, but it's in the Pasuk. Ketal Hermon, like the. Because the dew of Hermon is the purest, it's very high, the highest point. So I said now, but this level of dew coming down to the mountain of Zion. Donc il dit, donc ça descend, cette talle là, cette rosée là, descend sur les montagnes de Zion. C'est quoi les montagnes de Zion? C'est Netzar et Od, les deux Aravot, vers le tour Aravot. Umisham, Tochanim, Ze, Aman, la Tzadikim. And from that place, he's prepared the man. Tout le tzadikim, pour le tzadikim. De cette place-là, la man est préparée pour le tzadikim. Meaning that you are not tzadik, you cannot eat man. C'est-à-dire que tu n'es pas un tzadik, tu ne peux pas manger la man. Mais katish, katishin, la tête, la nukvea. And after it's worked, to be given to their wives. Après, c'est écrasé, pour que ça donne à leur femme. Ou beyesod zeata, ou beyesod zeata al, nikra amen. So this process we just saw, this is called amen. Ce processus qu'on voit s'appelle amen. It is man becoming one. Aleph, amen. Get it? Man, echad. Amen. And what he said is right. I mean, David, look now what he said. So, amen. Man be yichud echad. Man being connected to one, the man being in one yichud. Ve inikret emuna. So, what is emuna? Emuna is the feminine aspect of the man when it's given to the wives. What is the masculine aspect of the man? The man, not the man, yes, it's amen.
Amen, hey, it's the feminine.
Emuna, it's the feminine. and amen is the masculine. It means that that's dude that comes from the head of Ariel, the beard of Ariel, the beard of Aaron, given to the two Netzarot, which are basically for us the mountain of Zion, or you can call them the two Aravot we saw yesterday. Yeah. And after, when it's given, the masculine version is amen. The feminine version is emuna.
Comes down to hair of Aryeh, beard of Aryeh, beard of the Kenshel Aaron, Netzachod, masculine, feminine, amen, emuna.
Yes, just something you have to correct is the head of Aryeh, beard of Aryeh, the two, let's say the two, head of Aryeh, beard of Aryeh, beard of Aaron, after Netzachod, Tal Hermon, it's not here, it's here.
Ah.
See? Tal Hermon, it's with the mountain of Zion.
Mm.
It's not here.
Ah.
See.
Oh, okay.
So you mean? Vous avez suivi, vous suivez?
Yeah.
Vous avez compris?
Oui, oui, monsieur.
Abiri, ça va? Il est au travail.
Ouais, je crois.
Ok. Donc, c'est quoi la Emouna? C'est la manne des femmes. C'est quoi le Amen? C'est la manne des hommes. What is Emouna? The woman's man. What is Amen? The man's man. So you see that?
When she says Amen, say the bracha.
She has to say amen. It's halacha.
No, she does say, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that that's the oneness that's coming together.
Yes. Yes. Meaning that also, most of the time, men, they have emuna. But when they start to lose it a little bit, it's when they're married. Because she is the order of emuna. She has to handle emuna. And most of the time, men, women miss emuna. A lot of time.
Oh boy, man.
Why? Because Miss Verti couldn't. Every single situation where you have to work more than the other, it's for you to hit your tikkun. It's your identity. Toute chose que je dois faire plus que les autres, c'est là-bas ton identité. Meaning that the emuna is for them. The amen is for the men. The men may never say amen easily. Even the amen itself, you see the machloket. No, don't say baruch Hashem. Don't say amen. Why you say the machloket? Let me say amen. What's the problem with you? People don't like to say amen. Also, because this is one of the things that the goy took from us, and they use it a lot also.
I get an amen. This guy said to Rav Cohen about me and Indigo, these guys need to get married. Rav Cohen says, amen, amen. He says, no, one amen, not two. He started shouting at him, don't say two amen.
Like, yeah, exactly. We were like, why not? What's the problem with amen, amen?
Is there a problem with
that? No. Say what? No? It's like this you say, according to the sage. Like this you say. The next time you kill him, you say, amen, the emuna. You get it? This is the secret. So what the Zaken was saying yesterday is not a joke. Ce qu'il disait le Zaken hier, c'était pas une blague. C'était quelque chose de très sérieux, très profond. But it's very deep. You see now, and the emuna is the man of the feminine aspect. Vesham azivug bezera kodesh mitzvata. So when you have the amen and you have the emuna, the zivug is kadosh. No zerani vatala. Because the truth is, why a man start to think bad? Because we know that the man comes from the marshava. On a vu que le man vient de la marshava. So if you think bad, you're depressed, you're sad. What you do? We know. You try to find a solution. Warm hands. And some people go and cheat on their wife. Other people go and masturbate. We know. It's not like this. just, I don't feel good. I feel lonely, I feel sad. Oh, something for the woman. Everything starts from here. Marshavot.
It's funny that because looking like when a man cheats on a woman, she feels bad. It's the badness that she feels because he disgraced her,
mm-hmm.
cheated on her, or is it that she caught the guilt that she caused him to go to that place?
Mm-hmm.
It's not like a happy marriage where the man is cheating on his wife. Yes. He's depressed because obviously the house isn't a place that he wants to be.
Yes.
So I think that her deeper hurt is the fact that she had a piece in that.
Yes.
And she can't forgive herself.
Most of the women, when they know that they're cheating, basically they don't care so much about what's happened. What destroys them is that now she sees that she wasn't trustful, or she breaks something, or there's no trust between them. It's like something is over. It's not the fact that this happened. It's the fact that she sees now that the relationships are still in the same place. And that she is not the one, she's not the solution, like you said, yes. And the other, a very small percentage, they try to live it like going. You're like, okay, I will fight back, but women, they have this feeling that they have to take care of something. And things have to be smooth, working good. And this is like the guarantee that everything will stay. Yes. Yeah.
Because it's interesting because then you have the idea that if a man cheats on his wife, the wife isn't usher to her anymore.
Yeah.
But if the wife cheats on the
husband, it's finished.
It's finished.
Exactly.
Which means that there can be a repair of that relationship if they so choose, if they so choose. Like, it's a wake up call that, I mean, God forbid someone should cheat on their wife, but it's a wake up call for the wife that either she changes or nothing's gonna.
Yes.
And we see then the golf course becomes the best friend, or the boat becomes the best friend.
Yes.
Or the business becomes the best friend.
Yes.
And the woman, okay, so she spends the money, but she's still depressed. And lost.
That's very deep what you said. Everybody said it's like that. Il dit quoi en fait quand il y a histoire de tromperie, on voit par la Torah que l'homme qui trompe, il peut repartir avec sa femme, mais la femme qui trompe, elle peut plus repartir avec son mari. Il semblerait que la dimension de la tromperie, elle porte une dimension de la responsabilité bizarrement chez la femme. C'est-à-dire quoi? Celles qui, on va dire, le prennent d'une manière très haute, elles vont dire voilà, ça s'est passé parce qu'il y a quelque chose que je n'ai pas su tenir, parce que c'était dans ma sphère de protection, et je ne l'ai pas tenu comme il fallait, et ça m'a échappé. Ça, c'est ce que pensent les gens qui ont du recul. Les autres dont on ne parle pas, c'est ceux qui vont avoir l'envie de commettre des meurtres et tout ça. Mais l'idée, en fait, elle est là, c'est qu'il disait, il y a une dimension ici de Amen et Mouna, on voit qu'il y a une complémentarité. Et ça revient à ce que je dis, « Come back on what he said », that the emuna is feminine aspect. The amen is masculine aspect. Vesham zivu gazera kodesh bemitsa. Ve amen nikra bezivug avaya adanut. Aole. Amen. So he says what amen is the connection with avaya adonai. Gematria amen. 91. Il dit c'est quoi donc amen? C'est le yichud avaya adonai. Ça fait 91. Even and understand that. You don't want to explain, but it's big, very deep what you said. Ukshayored Ashefa Lavo Le Alma Nepirida. So now when that Shefa comes down and wants to enter this world of division, Alma Le Pierida Peruda, the world of division, the Munda Division. Quand the Shefa descend, elle doit rentrer dans la division. Aya Niglam Be Avirim Be Dalet Yisodot. Israël, Karou, Oto, Man, ויהודים סודות. So he said, when it was coming down to enter in Olam Hazeh, it was coming through the atmosphere from four, by using the four Yisodot, meaning ash, wind, fire, earth. And he said, the Bnei Israel, they knew the secret, and they called it man. And he said, I will not say more. You have to understand by yourself. I gave to you a lot, he said. I can. So,
take it around with it. All you got.
That's what it said here. That's what you said.
What is it? What's the event? When I got up and say the event, it's been that. And understand, you say, okay, it's enough. I cannot say more.
No. I just wanted to confirm something you have. If a man is masculine, not if, it is masculine, and emuna is feminine, are women obliged to respond to amen with amen?
Yes, like you said, to be complete. You have to show emuna, she has to know the lachot of amen. So like this, you're one. So now we're going to see the hardest part of Limut, or avoir la partie la plus dure du Limut. Get the Zohar Bereshit. Let's prendre le Zohar Bereshit. We're going to give a final definition about understanding about Amen, about Emunah and Bitachon. On va donner une définition finale par rapport à la Emunah et le Bitachon. Why the Nachash, why the Zaken? Bring it in that way. Et l'amène de cette manière-là. It's in the Adamot of the Zohar. Send the picture. What a photo.
Netzach is feminine and Hod is masculine.
Opposite.
Even on their other.
Hod is on the left side, so it's feminine.
Ah, what is it? Oh. Ah.
We'll understand now the secret of Bitachon and Emunah. Like this, we will have finished it.
No, because if we look in the. Right, there was that, it was going on all the time. No, because you had the golden calf.
Yeah.
What was happening in the golden calf? It wasn't just the golden calf, it was Vegas on steroids.
You are dangerous with the spoiling. Yeah? You are dangerous. You spoil my Hollywood. That's good. Yes.
Because
no,
you have to play with Aaron and Moshe. Aaron's up on Moshe's up on the mountain. Aaron's down below. There's chaos going on, and the men are cheating on their wasting seed.
Yes.
And then it goes to Baltior. Yes. Next time it's going to be Midian.
Yes.
And it's
like a thing. Very cheap. Yes.
And the mom comes back. I mean, like, to bring faith. Like, there's no bread, there's no Torah, there's no bread, there's no relationship. No bread in the
whole. Look what it say. Okay.
So, you have one?
You have all in the book, it's only in Aramean. It's good, like you like it's a string. On the right side, yeah. The red one. Just behind the yeah.
No.
On the left, yes.
Ah yes, yeah. which parasha?
It's the very beginning, Bereshit.
Yeah,
we have also here.
Here, Bereshit.
You want?
Yeah, okay.
Je ne sais pas quand je vais finir d'être dans la France. Regarde encore une fois le maillot bleu.
À qui tu parles, Didi?
Papa, l'ordinateur, il a parlé.
C'est moi qui ai parlé.
Regarde-moi maintenant.
Mais je te vois.
Alors, je te regarde.
Ouais.
Les lunettes oranges.
Qui c'est qui t'a donné les lunettes?
Oui.
Hein?
Oui.
Ah, qu'est-ce que tu me parles la bouche pleine? Je comprends rien.
Vous savez, Léo avec Carlos, il est en France. Ouais, il est à Béziers.
Ouais, pas à Strasbourg. Bien sûr, je te vois. Lui fait pas mal. Vous êtes dangereux tous les deux là. Oh, dis. Le laisse pas devant, le laisse pas devant. Voilà, mets-toi comme ça. Dis, t'es où? Non, cache-le.
Oui.
Regarde derrière toi, Didi, il y a quoi? Ah, il y a quoi derrière? Il n'y a rien. Et là, il y a quoi?
On a reçu la photo, you got the picture?
Oui, c'est bon, on a reçu.
Ok. Ok. Voilà ce qu'il dit non. Bereshit, Bereshit. Rabbi Eliezer Patar. Rabbi Eliezer, il ouvre la bouche. He's talking now. Seu maro menechem ureu mi bara ele. Raise your eyes and in the toward the sky. Look at the sky. And let me know who built that. Laissez-moi savoir qui a construit ça. So, keep in mind, you want to understand the difference, the connection between Bitachon and Emunah. C'est mi bara ele. C'est où marom enechem? Leze makom. So what does it mean to raise your eyes? C'est-à-dire pourquoi lève tes yeux? To which direction? Vers où? Makom shekol enaim truim bo. Send your eyes to the place where all the eyes are depending. Envoie tes yeux à l'endroit où tous les yeux dépendent. La makom shekol enaim truim bo. Umi où? And who is he? Patach petach enaim. This is the opening of the eyes. What is that? Or the openers of the eyes. Ce sont l'ouverture des yeux, celui qui ouvre les yeux. Vesham tedou chez Oto Satoum Atik chez Omed Lishela Bara Ele. Mi ou mi. And he said, you will understand now this place where I ask you to send your eyes, la place où j'envoie, je vous dis d'envoyer vos yeux, something is hidden there. Quelque chose est caché là-bas. A very whole thing, une vraie autre chose, antique. Hein? Ancient. Chez Omed, Bishela, is standing to question it. He's always questioning. We saw it for 1 week. Nachash loves questioning. He can be questioned. He questioned. He posed the question. Who is it? C'est qui? Me. It's me. Not me. It's me. Maybe you. C'est me. Who is me? The God of the Goyim.
Goyim.
Let's say me. The Nara is playing a role of Leah's team. But the me is called God of Goyim. And the me s'appelle le Dieu des Goyim. C'est qui ça? Me. Who is me? The master of questions. C'est qui me? Le maître des questions. Why I bring it to you? It's simple. When you start to have a lekef emunah, what do you have? A lot of questions. Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Quand tu commences à avoir un manque d'emunah, qu'est-ce que tu as? Plein de questions. First question, me. What is me? Who did me? Who did that? Who did me that? Who is behind that? Me? C'est qui me? C'est qui lui? Lui? Il? Qui? Qui quoi? Qui a fait ça? Qui m'a fait ça? First question. Oto shenikra mikta shamaim lemala. He said, this me which is called out from the shamaim. C'est ce me-là qui a appelé depuis les cieux. Shakol omed bereshuto. Everything is standing in his area. Ooh, it's not a fake God. He got some influence. The God me. Le Dieu me. Il a de l'influence, oui, il y a marqué. Il y a des choses qui sont sous sa domination. Ve al she omed le shela. And on this place, he's standing in questioning. Or for people who question themselves, people who question, let's say, the voice is not clear. Donc il dit, il se tient en questionnant, ou bien ces gens qui se questionnent, on ne sait pas encore. Mais où, mais derrière sa tombe, mais le haut, ni galé, ni crée, mi. He's giving you questions, interrogations, your doubts, your questioning. Your, it's not clear.
So is that, you said that before this thing?
Yes.
It's the input of this thing?
Yeah.
So then I'm just saying, because we're very cheap, guessing that this is talking about Eve,
exactly.
At the tree.
Yeah.
So he started playing with
questioning.
Exactly question.
Yeah.
What did he say? What is
exactly. So he doesn't
kill you.
Exactly. Exactly. Rabbi Binyamin, he said that it's the Nachash. I say maybe not. Not
it's
to
like
say
the
that.
Source of the
thank you. The soul of the Nachash.
Right.
So the Nachash and the me are discussing in the Midrash in the Mishpatim. When he said the soul is asking to the Nachash. So me, to me là, en fait, c'est l'âme du Nachash. The Nachash is questioning. But the question comes from your brain.
Your moach. So what is the moach of the Nachash? Me. The God me. What is the me? The last letter of Elohim. Look what he's going to say. Regarde ce qu'il va dire. Et c'est, it called me. It's called me. Who's talking the son of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai? C'est le fait de Rabbi Shimon qui parle ici. Share lemala en sham sheela. He said, why is the specific area? Pourquoi il a une zone spécifique? Because lemala, parce qu'en haut, no sheelot. Unquestioned. No question. Il n'y a pas de question. No doubt. Things are. It's okay. Parce qu'en haut, il n'y a pas de question. C'est vrai qu'il a une zone qui est plus bas où il se dirige.
Me doesn't have any power in Shemayim.
Yeah, exactly. Me. And me, it's not only two letters. It's a whole entity. It's a powerful entity. It's a God. It's a divinity. Divinity, you say? Yes, a divinity. Yeah. Questioning. Ve'en shem shayla ve'ze ketcha shamayim nikra mi. So, because we don't have any place for questions there, that's why we send him in the extreme part of Shamayim. He's not with the. He's not. It's a Shamayim.
He's
getting it. Go there. The question. Ve'yesh acher lemata anikra ma. Oh. He said, now what's happened? Me is there. In our, oh, me is in the top. He's in the Shamayim. When Nice comes here, I'm going to say, what's his name? Ma. If you want. Me, Ma. Who and what? The Zohar is deep. He said, quand c'est en haut, il s'appelle Mi. Qui? Mais quand il descend en bas, Rabbi Elazar dit, il s'appelle Ma. Quoi? Nikrama. Ma ben zelaze. What is this in that and that? People questioning. Ma, ma ze. Ma, ma, ma kara, ma kore, ma yesh, ma, 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 ma. This is also an entity. That's why the Yeshivat Mekubali say, stop questioning.
Don't
ask questions. Ne demande pas de questions, because if you start your question, Arav, mi yes. Arav, ma.
Even Lama,
it's also Lama. Yeah, Lemi. Always. This is God's. Yes.
Months back, we learned that don't call these entities. We were talking about some entities. Don't call them, because once you call them, and they will become problem for you if you just call them for nothing.
Yes.
Now, when I look at this now,
you're trapped.
It looks that we are trapped in this thing too. Now, what is that now?
You will see, it will help you to change the way you ask your question a lot. Me, it changed my life. When I saw with Tsugiya, when you say Tsugiya, I never start any question by me. Finished. I always give all the Tsugiya I've read or I've heard, and I say, Rabbi, look, it's written as Valikutin that there's no grapes on the vineyard, that there's no figs on the trees, and this is the Gilgul of Avakela. I think it's that. I think it's that. Nichoshad is it? And the Rabbi will answer, or not. You don't see me. Not a time when you see me, it's Lashon Hara. Who? Me? 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 Oh, what is it, me? No, don't say me. Me, I'm asking. Ma, what did he do? If you really want to ask a question, you first of all introduce your question, like in the parliament. Mr. Minister, yeah, Mr. President and all the ministers. We saw since the last week many events happen in the country, and that's why our political party want to know. Why the minister is planning to do for this situation? Thank you. You have no me, no ma.
Lema is why.
Lema, lemi, lema, lama. It's all the things. You have me and ma inside.
Lema is like four.
Yeah.
We have been the prosecutor in this. We say in our kind of world. And you say,
That's why David has such trouble in doing the doors, right? If that's me, and they're like, no, right?
Shem, who?
When he said, "Please, I'm not going to go," the gates were like, "We're opening." Then when he said, "Hashem," they were like, "We're opening." And he said it again, they were.
That's even in the Siddur, Rashash, Rosh Hashanah, all of the time you have me, you have precision for the Baal Tzibur, the Shadar Tzibur, to think Akadosh Baruch Hu, not to have his mind going under me.
Also, that's why those two passages are together. He's a, it's not me.
Voilà, it's Hashem. Like I said last week, that's why we, in the secret sort of tradition, we don't say, we don't say me, we say me, we don't have me. Don't say me, because
I'm trying to do that. Then that banished part of heaven, is that the lower? We had the diagram on the Tzitzum, is that the part where out.
Yeah. Because from that part, the question starts. We call this part the Sfakot in the Somsugiot of Etzchaim. Or Oprah, il s'appelle Ma. Quand il s'en bat, il s'appelle pas Ma. His name is Ma. Ma ben Zelazé. What between this and that? Qu'est-ce qui est en français ça? Et là, A Rishon Satum Nikrami, but don't be mixed up, ne soyez pas mélangé. The Rishon is called me. Le premier s'appelle me. Mais Omed, the Sheela, and he's standing to questioning. So, meaning, what do you think? If I have to connect me and Ma to Bitachon and Emuna. So, me will be Emuna. Because you say me is I. And Ma will be Bitachon. Because Ma is here. What is a Bitachon? I give my trust to a man if I make a mistake. But where the Emuna is built? From the do, from the head of Arir. So here is the root of Bitachon and Emuna. Ma, you fix Ma, you have the good Bitachon. Me, you fix me, you have the right emuna. Now look what he said. What am I asking you? Bekevan sheshoel ben adam u mepashpesh leistakel ladaat madrigat le madriga ad sof kol madriga. So what does me? Qu'est-ce qui fait me? It's questioning you. Or let's say you question yourself. Tu es toujours dans les interrogations. You always question. No answers. We had one discussion. Well, what I'll meet is before 2 hours. I can tell you, when someone is lost, question is even not talk. It's not questioning. We saw with the young tzaddik we have question. No answer.
Always when people come in.
Yeah, question. You see that it's not stable. It can be from outside or by yourself. But if I know that me is standing on the level of Marshava, so I know that the question here is for myself. I'm the first one who put myself in doubt. But je comprends en fait que si me, si il y a la Marshava, c'est que les premières questionnements ne vont pas venir de l'extérieur. The first question don't come from outside. Come from here. I start. Look, people, if you are honest with yourself, so that like woman, when someone wants to sing, they give a footy. What is the first thing he do? He question the halacha. He question the halacha. Who told that it's forbidden? Makatuv. He starts. You start by questioning. Commence par questionner.
That's why it's
called. Daraba. You spoiled me again. Oh, Hashem, I like the spoils. חוזר בשאלה. What is the man who is totally lost, who has totally lost his emuna? Comment s'appelle un homme qui a perdu totalement sa emuna? Il est choser b'shela, il retourne à la question. Ou lo choser b'teshuva, b'teshuva. He's not going to the answers. He's, parce que teshuva, repentance is also the same word for answers. Instead of going to the answer, he go to the questions. He go to the me, what's me? The God of Goyim. They are questioning. Who are you? You are Jews? What is Jews? What is this? What is that? They question every time. That's why many sages of Ashkenaz, they don't want to talk to them. They say, keep quiet. But you have to give them, because after what we saw, what they are able to do when they don't understand, it's better to teach them that we are not animals, we don't eat babies, we don't drink drinks, blood. No. But they question always, what is kashrut? Why you don't mix this?
That's what it says, that when you study Torah, you have to learn it so you know how to answer that question.
Daraba. You have to know how to give answer. This is a ritzadi. Daraba. This is not a spoil, this is a chidush.
You know, one of the, I don't know, the understanding is that the person has to study Torah to be able to give the proper answer to the question.
To know how to answer. Yes, yes. To have to know how to answer to Apikoros. Yes. Yeah. But about this sugi of the Zohar is just like Dama. He's telling you that question is not a lifestyle. Not the finals of your life to questions. You see now when we don't give them place in our Torah? Well, not pourquoi on ne donne pas la place aux philosophes de la Torah? Because if you came to me with questions, I know where you're from. Si tu viens avec moi avec des questions, je sais d'où tu es. What philosophy said? Ah, what is that? And they made the art of that. What is the art? C'est the art of questioning. Je fais l'art du questionnement. Here's the way you build a good question. Why? It's not we. We build answers. On donne des réponses.
I think my Rosh Hashivas in Kansari Kali Shabracha would say that the pattern of the Gemara, it doesn't start with the question. Meaning, if I want to attack someone's position, I have to first prove his position wrong before I put my position in, which means I don't attack with the question, I have to attack with it from his position. I don't ask, oh, why do you say that, Rob?
Yeah.
He says, what you're saying, it's true, however, there's this or that.
Yes.
You don't start with the question. You start with the attack of why his position is wrong.
Exactly.
And then now you can put in the position.
Exactly.
And he then has a chance to reply and say, oh no, you're seeing it from the wrong perspective. And this is what I'm actually saying.
Exactly.
But it doesn't start with the
question.
It doesn't allow a question on the floor.
On commence jamais par une question. La question, questionnement, c'est le Dieu mi. Mi ma. And he said, you question till bliss off. You never finished. You always have a question.
No, because you see also, I'm sorry, you also see with Rabbi Akiva, there's a bunch of sugyas where the heretic is asking questions and he answers, no, he said it with the black and the white. And the egg and the white egg.
Yeah, it's never stop.
Gives him a foolish answer. The answer fall in his ways or something like that.
Exactly.
You give him an answer that
necessary.
His question.
Exactly. Donc faut être mesuré. Le questionnement c'est le relié au mi. And after said, Kevan shemagia sham ma yadata ma istakalta ma ispashta ari akol satum kivatrila. So say the more you will ask, he ask, me, olamazay become ma. That's why it's the question that the angel asked to you. Is right? Look. Ma yadata, ma istakalta, ma pishpashta. This is the question of the angel. What did you study? Ma. Why? Because they know where you're standing. They use the tools to give you the possibility to show that you have answers now. They ask for you. What did you study? What did you learn? Nothing. Donc, il y a des questions, toutes questions, ça devient ma. Basically, simply, the me become ma. The ma will become me.
The same thing, masculine, feminine, c'est deux dimensions, féminin et masculin. Mais al sod ze, et sur ce sod là, on dat sod, katouv ma idecha, ou ma adam elecha. Et kacher, c'est le pasuk où il y a tout. Et kacher, necha bet amigdash. So when we lost the temple, quand on a perdu le temple, yatsa kol ve amar, ma idecha. Uma adamecha. So say that bat kol, it's in echa, echa bet. That bat kol, when it comes out from the bet midash, when the bet midash one was destroyed, cette bat kol qui est sortie quand le bet midash a été sorti, elle a demandé, ma eidecha, uma adamecha. What your testimony? What you looks like now? Uma adamecha lecha. Ve oto ma eidecha be kol yom vayom me ida'a. Bar, miyamim, kadmonim, shekatuv, eidot'i bachem, ayom et ashamayim, me'et aret. Ma adam, so he said, this question is talking about the earth and the sky, the heaven will be witness for you, for us, about what we see, like Moshe said, azinu shamayim ve shmu aret. Let's take it up a little bit. Ve ma adame lecha beoto tzura ma adame. So what do you look like now? What you look maintenant? Beoto tzura mamash itarti otra beatarot kedushot beasiti otra shilton al aolam shekatuv azot ha'ir sheyomar kelilat yofi vegomer. So he said basically, when we have the temple standing on our place, what do we have? We have witness being alive, and we have a shape. We look like we have something. We look like something. We are not like we have form. In form, we have form, not shape. But when the temple is destroyed, what do we miss? We miss, first of all, quand le temple est détruit, qu'est-ce qu'on va manquer? On manque d'abord de témoins. What are the what are the witness? C'est qui les deux témoins? Amen. Ve'emuna. This is them. Zayin Nukva. We saw in Tzvi Alekutim that Amen Emuna is the Yichud Avaya Adonai. Which is Avaya Za. Adonai Nukva. So when we lose the temple, Chad V'Shalom, we lost Zayin Nukva. Who are them? Amen, ve'emuna, meaning that it's very hard now to build it. Because when the temple is done by itself, no one can come and tell you, mi uma. You see, well, mi ma, look.
Yeah. No, that's what the Arabs are doing now.
Exactly.
We have this temple mount. This
exactly.
Temple mount.
Exactly.
What do you guys think? We have a temple. We worship that.
So quand le temple il est là, personne peut te dire quoi ou qui ou quoi. Si te dis qui ou quoi, je vais voir. Tu dis qui ou quoi? Tu dis, regarde, le temple est là. But when the temple is not here, they say you me. Ah, you stop. Ah, I had this rabbi talking about the Zohar, but we are Jewish. Okay, you're Jewish. Here's the temple. Go, get it. No, it's odd. Why? Because you don't have answers.
And the miracles, right? You point to the sky going up straight and the no flies.
Exactly. Exactly. That's why when the Sitrara want to push us out from the land, he tried to get us holy places. They said to prendre place Kadosh, why? Because you cannot say, look now. Say, me, ma. We don't have answers.
Right. Yeah. In fact, they point out the name Kadosh now, and they say, look.
Exactly. They even changed the name of the place. You call it Siloam, right? Don't say Siloam. It's person is Shiloach. Me Shiloach. It's the place. But change it, become Siloam. Instead of Shimon HaTzadik, we call Sheikh Jafra. Why Sheikh Jafra? Shimon HaTzadik.
And then you have Yosef HaTzadik,
Nablus, Shrem, but change. Like this, when we ask you, me, ma? You just start to worship the God, me and the God, ma. Say, I don't know, but I'm Jewish now. I'm a simple Jewish. What simple Jewish? You say, he put on you
crown of glory. Look, atarat. Il t'a mis sur toi il t'a couronné. But what brings that crown to be seen? Answers. Qu'est-ce qui amène qu'on voit cette gloire-là? Les réponses. La question de David. You miss answers, you're done. You question too much, you're done. On va laisser là. קראתי אותך ירושלים, הבנויה כעיר שחורבה לאה. מה אשווה לך? כמו שאתה יושבת כך, הוא כביכול למעלה. כמו שלא נכנסים עכשיו בך. העם הקדוש בסדרים קדושים. בסדרים קדושים. כר נשבעתי לך שלא יכנס אני למעלה, עד שכנסו בר אוכלוסייך למטה. וזהו נחמה שלך. הועיל שמדרגה זו האישים לך בכל, ואתה שאת כאן גדול קיים שבריך. ואם תאמרי שאין בך קיום ורפואה, מי ירפה לך ודאי. So he said, talking about Yerushalayim now. What we understand, that the status of Yerushalayim, qu'est-ce qu'on comprend là, il parle de Jérusalem. On comprend que le statut de Jérusalem is connected to the fix of me. Because he said, who will heal you? Me. C'est qui va te guérir? Me, Yerfay, Lecha, Bevadai. Meaning, stopping questioning to having bitachon emuna. Without doubt, is the key. But look at now. Regardez maintenant. Who have answers? Qui a des réponses? Non. I say with a lot of sadness. You go to Bethel, you say, Corona, what's the way to do? No answer. You go to see Rav Arashi Ashkenazi. Rav Arashi Sfaradi, Corona, what do we do? Answer, please. No, do what the government tell you to do. No answer. Me is the boss. And he said, every time we don't have answered, Yerushalayim cannot be rebuilt.
There were so many people with answers before now, and Yerushalayim wasn't rebuilt.
And these who have answers, a shameful purpose put them in the position where they don't listen to them. Right. Donc, qu'est-ce qui se passe pendant la génération où il n'y a pas de gens qui répondent? Les questions restent ouvertes. Il n'y a aucun aujourd'hui, je serais beaucoup triste, il n'y a aucun aujourd'hui qui est capable de répondre à des questions. Tout le monde dans l'interrogation. Il va dire, « Ah, comme ça, Bezrat Hashem, it's like the ten makot. Ok, but give me answers. Don't give me comparison. Give me answers. »
But the answer is simple.
But even that, they don't have the strength to say that. Même ça, ils n'ont pas pour le dire. They tell you close your message. Ask for the green pass before they enter in the bucket message. This is the answer? No, this is the question. You are lost.
So what you're saying is that me and Ma has entered into the realm of Torah.
We are the boss. We even have a whole section of Torah's learning which is connected to what they call philosophia. The question, every time.
Jewish thought.
Yes. They say we are not here to find answers. We are here to questions. Rabbi Shimon, two pages, is telling you, we know you are. I'll say look at you.
And that was part of the reason why they put the guy to the perplexed in the harem.
Yes.
Don't even plant a seed of question.
Exactly.
At the time, for Rambam, it was probably necessary. But Allah come back and just forget about it. Don't even plant a seed of questioning. Just yes, you're fucker.
Exactly. We get it. So let's finish. Continue tomorrow, what we understand now. Qu'est-ce qu'on comprend maintenant? What the Nakhash was saying yesterday. Qu'est-ce que Nakhash nous disait hier? Was teaching to us something. Why, basically, there is some secret you cannot tell to people? Secret of Torah, of course. Because we still.
Funny because that's how Arizal ended. He ended the piece by saying.
What is dangerous to say to someone a truth that is not ready to listen? Qu'est-ce qui est dangereux à dire à quelqu'un une vérité qui n'est pas prêt à entendre? When he's trapping the me. Parce qu'il est coincé dans le me. Why? Because the thing that Hashem hates the most is when you question the innate. La chose que Dieu déteste le plus, c'est quand tu questionnes la vérité. So when you are a teacher, tzaddik, and you have to, you know the answer, but you know that the guy, the tzaddik, the student will question after that, don't say. Because he will have problem. This will be called lack of bitachon. People say, Baba, I'm sick. Donc on dit, pourquoi on ne dit pas des vérités trop tôt, les gens qui sont pas prêts, parce qu'ils sont concernés dans le mythe. Et il n'y a pas une chose que Dieu déteste le plus que d'interroger une vérité. Donc c'est pour ça que quelqu'un qui pose une question, tu dois voir si il la pose, est-ce que la réponse que tu as donnée, il va la prendre sans la questionner. So people come say, Rabbi, oh, you know, I'm sick, I want to be healed. You say, okay. Do Shabbat properly. Light your candles. And fix your anger. And look at you see. That's it. Finish. He's missing him now. That's why Rambam said, you have 13 levels of emuna. If you don't give your trust to God, to Hashem, you give it to a man. If I say, read that, do that, you say, Rabbi, I'm a doctor. So what do you think I'm telling you, Shriyot? You're questioning what they said. You know, what will happen to you? Aravot without waters.
What?
Aravot without waters. And you will finish like this. But don't say that because you have to be friendly with each other. That's why we, most of the Mikubai, we don't like to talk to people. Because people have Zera Levatala from here easy. Bah, 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 bah. You ask me a question, I give you an answer. If my answer was me doing, maybe, okay, I understand. But if I took the book, I open with you, I read with you, I say, here's the answer. You say, so, many American people, so, need the soul. Yeah, God gives you the book. You read, you say so. That's why people don't talk. They don't teach even. Many Mikubai are not best to get students. I stop. The cost is too heavy. I stop. You don't understand. C'est ça le secret de pourquoi on ne dit pas tout à des gens qui ne sont pas prêts parce qu'ils vont questionner la vérité. Quand je questionne la vérité, c'est ce qu'on appelle un manque de bitachon. C'est juste dire une vérité, pas de ma tête, en disant, oh, je réfléchis. À partir d'un livre, et que tu me dis, non, mais c'est tout. Genre, et alors, c'est fini. T'as questionné le Emet, ça s'appelle manquer de bitachon. Et qu'est-ce qu'il a dit, Yirmiyahu, Arur, Agever, Acha Iftar, Ba'adam. Et c'est ce qu'il a dit, Yirmiyahu, ici. What say Yirmiyahu? Cursed be the man who put his trust in the man. It will finish. Like we know. Without Hashem, we continue. And we're going to finish the Myanmar. We're going to go back to Southern Mishpatim.
Baruch Adonai Olam. Amen ve amen. Any questions? Ça va?
Ça va.
Yes, Rabbi Okuma. You have a question?
I don't know whether it's a question, but it's an experience.
Yes.
Of trust or bitachon and the emunah.
Yes.
Sometimes some of these students, they will just say, oh, I need something from rabbi. They will go to rabbi. Rabbi will tell them, go, okay, I know your problem. Go and meet Okuma. It will be solved.
Yes.
Then maybe I will examine the case. I will say, okay, do you do tikkun hazot? Say no. Do you do this? Say no. Okay, start with that before we talk about what the rabbi said.
Yes.
Some of them, they don't come back. They don't come back.
Exactly.
What I just tell them, are you doing this? Say no. Yeah, do those essential things first before we talk about what rabbi asked us to do. They don't come back. You know?
Exactly. You probably define the situation. This is a big, big work we have to do. I think with the student this year is to build the concept of emunah and bitachon. But not like we see people talk, use bitachon, use emunah, sometimes without understanding what is behind. I think this should be the title line of this year of Limud. We're gonna start in Elul. We will open the gates, but we have to learn more about bitachon and emunah. And the topic is huge, and it's open many, 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 many ways. And I think this is what we need now. At least we don't practice, but by studying, Hashem will find some merit for us, and we will have answers.
Hashem.
Bye bye, Tzadikim.
Thank you.
Bye bye, Tzadikim.
Bye bye. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.